Welcome back to stage 4 of this advanced demo series, and at the end of stage 3, this is the architecture that you have implemented. You've copied over all of the non-database assets across to the AWS WordPress application instance, and it's still pointing at the on-premises database. Now, you did provision an RDS implementation in the previous stage, and that's where we're starting in stage 4. We're going to complete a database migration from CatDB through to this RDS instance using DMS. So what we'll be doing is creating a DMS replication instance and using this to replicate all of the data from the CatDB on-premises database instance across to RDS. It'll be using the DMS replication instance to act as an intermediary, and it will be replicating all the changes through to the RDS instance. Now, when you're replicating data using DMS, you have a choice of either doing a full replication or a full plus CDC replication. Now, if you have a high volume application where you expect continued operations on the on-premises side while you're doing the migration, then you might want to pick full plus CDC. In our case, for this advanced demo lesson, what we're going to do is just a standard full migration. So we're not going to capture any changes, we're just going to migrate the state of the database from CatDB through to the RDS instance. Now again, there's no significant changes between doing a full or a full plus CDC, and if this were a production migration, you would use both of these in combination. Now let's get started on performing this migration. So we need to move to the AWS console, and first we need to move to the DMS console. So click on the services dropdown, type DMS, and then click to move to the database migration service console. Now this has an architecture similar to RDS in that we need to create a subnet group to get started. So click on subnet group and then create a subnet group. The name of this subnet group is going to be A4L DMS SN group, and we'll use the same for description. Click on the VPC dropdown, and because the DMS replication instance is going to be in the AWS side, you'll need to pick AWS VPC. Scroll down and then click on the Add Subnets dropdown and select AWS-Private A and AWS-Private B. These should be using the IP ranges of 10.16.32 and 10.16.96. Once you've got those selected, go ahead and click on Create Subnet Group. Once that's created, the next step is to create the replication instance itself. So click on Replication Instances and then Create Replication Instance. For the name and the description, we're going to use A4L on-prem to AWS. For the instance class, to keep this as cost-effective as possible, select dms.t3.micro. Scroll down under VPC, click in the drop-down and select AWS VPC. Now make sure that multi-AZ is set to dev or test workload single AZ, and make sure that publicly accessible is also unchecked. We don't need it to be publicly accessible because the databases that we're migrating are both accessible with private addressing within the VPCs and across the VPC peer. If one of the databases which were being migrated was an externally accessible database, then we would need to pick publicly accessible. Expand Advanced Security and Network Configuration and just make sure that A4L DMS SN group is selected for the replication subnet group. And then in the VPC Security Group section, click in the drop down and just go ahead and select AWS Security Group DB. Again, don't mind the start, and there will be some random at the end, but make sure you're selecting AWS Security Group DB. Once that's done, that's all of the configuration required for the replication instance, you can scroll down and click on Create. Now at that point, we can go ahead and configure the endpoints. You can think of these as the containers of the configuration for the source and destination databases. First, we'll be configuring a source endpoint. So go ahead and click on Endpoints and then Create Endpoint. Now it's a source endpoint, so make sure that option's selected and it's not an RDS DB instance, so uncheck that box if it is checked. For Endpoint Identifier, layer, let's call this CatDB on-premises. And for the source engine, click in the drop-down and select MariaDB. Now, there are lots of options for source database engines. You can select any of these as appropriate for your particular migration, but in our case, we're using MariaDB. So select that option. Now, at this point, you can provide the configuration information to DMS either using Secrets Manager or you can provide access information manually. So that's what we're going to do. So click the box that says provide access information manually. Now, for the server name, that's going to be the private IP address of the on-premises database server. So to get that, click on Services. Type EC2 in this drop-down and then open that in a new tab. Just go to Running Instances, select CatDB and copy down its private IP version 4 address. And then paste that in under server name. Because this is MariaDB, the port to use is 3306. This will depend on the engine type that's being used. Different database products have different port numbers, but for MariaDB, this is 3306. For username, we need to use A4L WordPress. And for the password, it's this same DB password. So we're using the same password throughout. So enter that into the password box. And that's all of the configuration required. So we can go down and click on Create Endpoint. We're going to follow the same process again for the destination endpoint. So click on Create Endpoint. It's going to be a target endpoint and it's an RDS instance. So check that box. And that will allow you to select the RDS instance from the drop-down, and that will pre-populate a lot of the configuration options. We'll need to again click the checkbox to provide access information manually. What you will need to enter is the password, and again, it's this same password that we're using throughout. So just enter that into the password box, and then scroll down and click on Create Endpoint. Now at this point, what I want to do is to test the endpoints and make sure they're functioning as expected. So once the UI updates, go ahead and select one of the endpoints. Let's start with A4L WordPress. So check this box, click on Actions and Test Connection. Wait for this to load and then go ahead and click on Run Test. Now what you might find here is that you're told that the replication instance A4L on-prem to AWS is not active. So if you do see this message, what you'll need to do is wait for the replication instance to finish provisioning. So in my case, if I go to replication instances, you can see that the status is still creating. So if yours is also still creating, you'll need to pause the video and wait for this to change to available. Once it's changed to available, you can go back to endpoints, select the A4L WordPress endpoint again, go to Actions and Test Connection, and then click on Run Test. At this point, it's testing the ability of DMS to connect to one of your database endpoints. And after a few minutes, what you should see is the status should change from testing to successful. At this point, go back to Endpoints and select the other endpoint. In my case, CatDB on-premises. And we're going to do the same thing. So click on Actions, Test Connection, and then Run Test. You'll need to wait for this to complete and it should change from testing to successful. Now, if it does, that's great. It means everything's working as expected. If you get errors for either of these endpoint connections, then you need to go back and diagnose why you're having connectivity issues. Now, once both these are successful, we need to go ahead and create the database migration task. So click on Database Migration Tasks and then Create Task. So this is the thing that uses the replication instance together with both of these endpoints that we've just configured. For the task identifier, we're going to use A4L on-prem to AWS WordPress. Click in the replication instance drop-down and select the replication instance. Click in the source database endpoint and select CatDB on-premises. Click in the target database endpoint and select A4L WordPress. In the migration type dropdown, we'd have the ability to just replicate changes only, to migrate existing data and replicate ongoing changes. And this is the one that you would pick for a high volume production database, or you can just do a one-off migrate existing data. And that's what we'll be doing in this demo lesson. So select migrate existing data and then scroll down all the way down down to table mappings. Now we need to define what data we want migrated. So make sure that editing mode is set to wizard and then click on add selection rule. Now the schema, which is just another way of talking about the database name, the thing that contains tables, we need to set this to enter a schema. Now inside the simulated on-premises environment, on the self-managed database, all of the data is stored within a database called A4L WordPress. And so we need to enter that for schema name. So it's going to migrate that entire database. And because we're using percent as the wildcard, we're going to be migrating any tables within this database. So this is all we need to do. This is the migration task. We've defined the source and destinations and the replication instance to use and the type of migration. And we've defined what exactly we want to migrate, which is the WordPress database. Now we can scroll all the way down to the bottom and click on Create Task. Now this starts the replication task and it's doing a full load or a full migration from the source, which is CatDB on-premises, which references the CatDB simulated on-premises virtual machine database server, and it's transferring all this data through to the RDS instance, which is A4L WordPress. Now this will go through a number of different states. It'll start off in the creating state, then it will move to the running state, and then finally it will move into load complete. And we need to wait for all of those steps to finish. So if you keep hitting refresh, you'll see that it moves into a starting state. This is beginning to load the configuration onto the replication instance and begin the process of migration, so it will remain in the starting state for a few moments. Then it will move into the running state, and because the database that we're migrating is relatively small, it will quickly move to the load complete state, and that means the process is completed. The database migration service has migrated all of the data from the on-premises self-managed database through to RDS. Now that that's complete, the next step is to cut over the AWS web application server so that instead of pointing at the on-premises database instance, it now points at the RDS instance. So to do that, we need to go to Instances. Let's just close down any of these excess tabs. Select AWS CatWeb, right-click, select Connect, Session Manager, and then click Connect. Again, we need to elevate our permissions, so sudo space bash, then move into the web folder, cd space /var/www/html. Now WordPress has a configuration file which is called wp-config.php, so we need to edit that using the nano editor, so nano space wp-config.php. Scroll down. There's a definition for the database host, and this has the IP address of the on-premises database server, so we need to delete this. Then we need to go to the RDS console, and we need to get the DNS name of the RDS instance. So go to Databases, select the A4L WordPress instance, and then copy this endpoint DNS name into your clipboard. Then back in this configuration file, just paste that in. Press Ctrl-O to save and Ctrl-X to exit. And this means that WordPress is now pointing at the RDS instance. Now there's one final thing that we need to do. WordPress has a strange behavior that the IP address that we installed the software on and first provisioned the database is hard-coded into the database. So we need to update the database so that it points at our new instance IP address. Now the script to do this is contained within this lesson's instructions. So you need to copy that entire block of text and just paste it in and then press enter. Make sure that you press enter after every line. Now what this does is to load the config of that file that you've just edited, so wp-config. It gets the database username, the database password, the database name, and the host, and it uses all that information to essentially replace the old IP address with the new information of this instance. Now that's something that when I automate WordPress, when I make elastic architectures, I have to make sure that this is run all of the time whenever whenever a new instance is provisioned or terminated. But in this case, we run it manually just to make sure that this new instance loads correctly. Now at this point, if we go back to the AWS console, and let's just move across to EC2, we're going to go ahead and shut down both of the on-premises instances. So move to running instances, select CatWeb, right click, and then stop, and then click stop to confirm, and do the same to CatDB. So right click, and then stop the instance. And this is going to shut down both of the simulated on-premises virtual machines. So all that we have running at this point is the AWS-based WordPress web server, which should now be pointing at the RDS instance, which should now contain the migrated data that was copied across by the database migration service. So once both of these have stopped, go ahead and select AWS CatWeb and copy its DNS address into your clipboard and then open that in a new tab. All being well, it should load in the Animals for Life Hall of Fame together with all of the images. So Patches the Wondercat, the chickens, and my cats. And if that is the case, then you've successfully migrated a database using the database migration service. Now, this same process can be used to migrate large, complex databases, either using the full load or full load with CDC type migration. The same concepts are used no matter the size or complexity of the database. So all of the skills that you've learned in this advanced demo series can be used for database migrations of all different sizes and levels of complexity. Now, the database migration service can be used together with the schema conversion tool, and that's used if the engines at both sides of this migration are not compatible. But again, that's something that's only used for complex migrations. At this point, though, you've done everything required in this advanced demo series. All that remains is to tidy up the account and return it to the same state as it was at the start of this demo series. But that's something we're going to do in stage 5. At this point, go ahead and complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in stage 5, where we'll clean up the account.